Greetings to you, precious viewer. Welcome to the fourth video tutorial of Photoshop by Prime World. Now, in this video, we are going to be looking at the layers property of the Photoshop software, the layering properties of Photoshop software. As you should know, this is one of the things that makes Photoshop a very unique graphic design software because of its layering capabilities. And layering capabilities just simply means the ability to put objects in their different layer, in their different compartment, separate from themselves, so that if you adjust one part of the layer, it will not affect the others. And if you want to see where the layers panel is, you just move to the right, this panel here, and you can see this one called layers. All right, so just to show you the workings of these layers, we are going to open an image and work with it. So I just simply go to file and open, or you can see the shortcut there, Control O, and you just click on it. And let me pick the image. Let me just go and pick the image that I want to use. So let's see. Let's say I use, okay, this nice one. Okay, so it's opening up. So imagine if I wanted to use this image now. And if you notice, as I open the image, look at the layers area, the layers panel. You can see that a layer thumbnail and a layer has been created. Okay, now because this is the first object in our design panel, in our design work, you know, it is called the background because this is the first object we opened or we placed into our work area. Is the first thing we opened, so it is called the background. Okay, so yeah, so one thing you need to know is for you to apply some adjustments to this image that is viewed as the background now, you need to unlock the background. It is by default locked. So if you just left click on the padlock icon, it unlocks that layer. And if there's anything you need to know, this picture here is simply the layer thumbnail. That's the thumbnail of the layer. Now what if I wanted to do like a very minimal design with this image? That is, I wanted to add some design elements to this image. Now, this is where the power of layering comes in. I could decide to, you know, draw, let's say I draw a rounded rectangle. Now, we are going to be looking at the tools panel in a later video, so you don't need to worry yourself too much about learning this. I'm just using this to give you a hands-on feel on how layers work. So what if I want to use this rounded rectangle to create a shape? So I just drag that shape. All right, and I create it. Now, I can either use this properties panel, or I go to the properties bar. Okay, so I want to change the color to something like, let's say, purple. Okay, something like purple. And yeah, Now, our focus is not really on the design per se. Now, our focus is more or less what just happened at the layers panel. You can see that in creating this image, object, this rounded object, a new layer was created separate from the image layer. Do you see that? So that's one powerful thing about layering. Now, if this was not possible, what in case I dropped this image and it was part of this image, what if I wanted to make an adjustment? I may not be able to make an adjustment because this rounded rectangle is now part of the image. But because of layering, I can choose to make adjustments to the object, the rounded object I created, separate from the image so that it doesn't affect what I have done previously to the image. So I can come here and choose to click on the layers, the layer for the rounded object, and choose delete. And you can see that it didn't affect the image. But if I had created this and there was no layers, if I press delete, it will have affect, since they are just one layer, they are in just one layer, it will affect everything. So let me just control Z that. Okay. And let's place something else now. Let's place another object. Let's say I want to place an image into this design that we've started. Okay. Now we can simply go to File. Let me show you one way. We can go to File, Open. And let's say I want to place another image. So let's say I want to place, let's see now. Which image should I choose now? Let's say I wanted to place something like, I think I had something like a CD or so there. So I'm searching for it. I believe I had something like a CD. Let me check very well. I believe I have something like a CD. Like I want to place a CD, a compact disc, in the work. Still searching for it. Please hold on. Where is it? Happen to see it, but I had a CD. I want to use a CD because, please excuse me, let me really check for this. Yeah, this is what I'm looking for, CD case. Okay, so what if I wanted to place this CD case into, you know, my design work? Now I wanted to show you that first method, but I'm going to show you a quicker method in inserting an image into an already opened image into your workspace. So all I need to do is just go to the place in your computer where the image is, left click and drag with your mouse or with your touchpad, and drag it to your taskbar where your Photoshop software is open. It opens up this Photoshop software, and just come here. You can see that arrow key with the plus sign is telling you that you're about to add something to the document, and just release your hand. Okay. And you can see that it adds this the image that we wanted. Okay, so this is for the quickest way, more or less the quickest way to, is a way of importing an image, or you know, an image in into your workspace. Okay, the other way I wanted to show you was that you just go to file, go to open. Okay, and since I couldn't find the image here, let's just imagine I wanted to insert this image. I just left click on it, it opens up in its different window. So all I need to do is making sure that I'm on the move tool. Take note, you have to be on the move tool. You just click and drag it and move to the window where your design work is currently positioned, and you see this arrow key shows again, and you release your mouse and it drops the image. Okay, so this is the second option of, you know, putting an image into another image that you are working on. Now, so I've inserted this CD, okay, and now notice as I inserted the CD, it is now in its own layer too. It's separate from the rounded rectangle and the image itself. So this is one powerful thing about layering, okay? Now, one thing you need to know is that you can move layer the objects in a particular layer up or down. You understand? You can, what I'm trying to say is you can move it into any position you want it to be. For instance, if I wanted to move this CD behind the rounded rectangle, I just simply go to the layer where the CD is located and I left click and drag and I put it behind the layer for rounded rectangle. Now take note of that line that showed. That line that just showed on that, are you seeing that line that shows? It's telling you that if you release your hand now, it will be placed behind or under that rounded rectangle. So if I release my hand, it's going to be placed under the rounded rectangle. And as you can see, because it is under the rounded rectangle, it is no more showing. It's because it's behind it. Okay? So this is how you can place objects, you know, in front or behind. I can go ahead and move my image and place it to the top. And you see that it blocks every other thing behind. So let me undo what I've done several times by pressing Ctrl Alt, then Z several times, Z again, and it takes me back to where it was before. Now, there's another thing I want to teach you concerning the layers panel. Okay, now what if I wanted to add another image? Like if I added, maybe I added another rounded rectangle. Let me just assume that I add another rectangle because I want to work more on my, is this rounded rectangle? Okay, let me change this to 20 by 20. Yeah, okay, let me change the color, let me change it to red now. All right, so I added another rounded rectangle and I want to place it in front. You can see I'm dragging it. I want to place it in front of the CD image. So I drag it in front and I just place it there. Okay. Now, and I wanted to add another element. Let me say I go to the custom shape tool. Okay. We are going to be looking at the tools panel later, so you don't need to worry yourself, like I said earlier. So, and I want to insert this shape, this particular shape, okay, like play shape. So I click and drag it to insert it. Then I come here. I don't want an outline, that's what stroke means. I just want a fill. I just want it to be filled with white. okay, then I'm just using the move tool, I just move it somewhere around there, okay. So now we've just inserted two extra shapes. Look at the new rounded rectangle we inserted, and look at the shapes we inserted. Now there's what we call grouping, okay, grouping layers, because as you advance in designing and you start doing more complex works, you see that you will be creating a lot of layers, because as you add objects, more layers are created. There are some design works you may have up to 50 layers, you understand, and because of that it may be very crowded. So you may need to group certain layers, that is, put certain layers into a singular group, so that, you know, for the sake of making your work neater, okay, and more easier to navigate. So for instance, for now I have created two rounded rectangles, okay, and a shape that is also connected with the rounded rectangle, which is this arrow like shape. So what if I wanted to group all the rounded rectangles and the shapes into one group, and I put all the layers into that particular group, so that I know that that group is specifically for rounded rectangles. You will be doing things like this when you design, okay, grouping layers that are related into a particular group. So all I need to do is I just need to create the group, okay. So seeing that this is where the shape layer is, I can click here. Now take note, before you add a layer, you can also add layers, okay, to your layer panel. Now before you add a layer, you need to specify the layer that is active. You need to be active on a particular layer, and whatever you do next will be inserted on top that layer that you are active in. For instance, now I want to create a new group. Now because I am active in this layer, when I click on the new group icon, create a new group icon, you can see it there. When I click on it, the new group will be inserted just above the layer I was active in previously. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say, okay. So let me undo this. So if I was active in this CD case layer, as I left clicked on it, now just once being active, just left click on it once, okay. If I choose create group, you see that the group will be created on top the CD case, the layer that I was previously active, okay. So let me just move this group I just created to the very top. You can leave it there if you want. Now currently this group, if you can see this arrow, okay, is this arrow, when you click on it, it's showing you that the group is open. Now when you click on it again on the arrow, it shows that the group is closed, but currently the group is empty. We just created a new group, but we have not put any layers into the group. As you can see, the group is like a briefcase that should contain stuff. So now I can now choose to specify which objects should be inside that group. So I want the shape, I want the rounded rectangles, okay, I want the shape and I want the rounded rectangles to be inside that group, okay. So all I need to do now is if you want to select multiple layers, all you need to do is left click on one, then hold down your control key, left click on the next one you want to select. Now I want to go to the third one and I left click on it. Take note, as I held the control key down, it was selecting them without going away from the previously selected ones. So you can see that we have three layers selected. Now all I need to do now is to click and drag and place them inside this group one. So when I left click, you see what happens? please watch very carefully. When I left click, it shows me the ones that are going to be moved. Now, as I move, you will see that line. You see that line that showed there. It's telling me that it will be placing it under the group one. But if I move it again, you can see that border that appeared on the four corners of the group. Take note of the difference. This one is telling me that I want to place it under the group. If I move it up, it's telling me that I want to place it above the group. That line that appeared, that white line that appeared at the top. But if I move it in the center and the four borders are showing white, it's telling me that I want to insert it into the group. So make sure that these four borders, these four white lines appearing on the borders of the group one layer is showing. Then you release your hand. Now, once you release your hand, as you can, if you notice, there's an indent. Take note. Look at this layer. But if you look at these three layers we just inserted into the group, there's an indent. There's a space here just to show you that it's now inside the group. So I can choose to close the group now. And as I close the group, you notice that the rounded layers are no more showing because they are now inside of the group. Okay. And just as we can position objects in the layer panel, you can also position objects that are inside the group. You can place it on top. You can place it behind. Okay. If you wish. So this is how you can insert layers into groups. Now, as you can see, because the group was above the CD, it has blocked the CD image. So let's just drag the CD up. So take note, if I leave it now, it will enter the group. So I need to drag it more up until this white line shows at the top. Then I release my hand. Okay. So it's now above the group. So this is more or less how layering works. And one other thing you need to know for now about layering is that you can delete a layer if you want. Like now, if I wanted to delete this CD, okay, I could choose to just click on the CD layer and I press the delete key on my keyboard. That's one way to do it. Let me undo that, Control Z. Or you can press, highlight the, select the layer you want to delete. And look at this option, look at this icon here that says delete layer, okay? Look at this icon that says delete layer, it's for deleting. So make sure you are selected on the layer you want to delete and just press the delete icon. It will ask you whether you want to delete the layer CD case and you press yes. And it deletes it. Okay, so let me undo that. Now, finally, what we will learn concerning this layering is how to rename your layer, your layers, if you want to rename it. Okay, so imagine for by default it gave this name layer zero. Okay, but what if I wanted to give it a name that I could relate to? And it's a good practice you do this, so that if another person is seeing your design, they can understand what each layer is all about. So I can come here and rename my layer. I just need to go to this place where the name is written and left click once. Now, when you left click once, it will select the layer. But once the layer is selected, left click on that place where the name is written. Left click again. Okay, I'm sorry. I don't think you left click once. You double click on it. Sorry. Double click on it quickly. That is, tap on it twice quickly. Then it opens up like this. Okay? Make sure it's on the written word that you are clicking, not outside it. If you double click outside it, something different will happen. Okay? So, this is how you can rename it. So, you come here and you just write image. You can just name it image. Okay, so once you rename it, just click once outside it and it is affected. Okay, so you can rename a group too. Just okay, click once to select the group, then double click on the group text. Okay, just like we did. Then you can name these rounded rectangles. Okay. You can also use shorthand for you to, in case you are just the one working on the work. Now, so this is how you can rename your layers or group. Now, finally, what I want to make you know is every layer has its properties. Okay. Every layer has its properties. Now, if like this, if I go to, let's say, let's open, which one do we open now? Let's work on this particular rounded rectangle that has red, this one. Okay, now if I double click twice, just on the layer here, not on the text now, just around here, if I double click on it, okay, it opens up the layer style. It's a place where you go to put styles to your layer. Okay, so if you open it now, when we start designing stuff, you will get to understand this layer style better, but I just want to introduce it to you now. So here it's the layer style. If you want to add effects, like now we are working on this rounded rectangle, if you want to add styles to your rounded rectangle, you open up this layer styles. Okay, now there are different options. There's the bevel and emboss. If I tick on bevel and emboss, okay, and if I tick on it, it puts an effect on it. I don't know if you can see what happened, but if I untick it, you can see that there was an effect that happened. Let me tick it again. Now you can go ahead and adjust the style that this bevel emboss puts to your object. So if I left click on the rectangle for bevel and emboss, it opens up the properties for bevel and emboss at the right side of this window, okay, of this dialog box. So you can now choose to specify the kind of emboss you want, the depth. You can play with options here, okay, in case you wanted to add a bevel and emboss effect to your object. I will not be going into details on each of these effects for now, because while we do designs, we'll be working on them, but just for you to have a feel on what it is. Okay, so you can, anyone you click, any of these layer style options you click, okay, you click, they have their effects. Okay, like now I just clicked on the stroke effect and you can see what happened. When I click on it, the stroke properties show up here. So you can see the orange stroke it puts here. So I can decide to reduce the size of the stroke here. I can decide to make the stroke come inside. Okay, like you see now. Let me leave it at outside again so that you can see it. Then I can make the blend mode. Okay, a different blend mode entirely. I can, the opacity, that is the visibility of it, I can reduce it or increase it. So these are the different options that the stroke layer, the layer style has. You can go for inner shadow too, you can go for inner glow, you can go for satin. They all have their different properties that you can tweak and work on. So this is what you need to understand. For now, this is just an introduction. This is a major, you know, topic, but I'm just introducing you to it. And notice, anyone you click on, it adds the styles to it. So if you want to remove a particular style, just untick the box and that style will be removed. Okay, so that's for that. So that's what you, for now, that's what you need to know about layer styles. Like I said, when we start creating works, we'll be using the layer styles very well. But for now, just play around with it. Go to each of the layer styles and just tweak their properties and see the effect they have on your object that you are active on. All right, so let me just click cancel. So this is more or less what you need to know about layering and the power of layering in Photoshop. So I hope you learned something very valuable, and see you in